Now that there's a file imported to IDEA, let's talk about formatting. Formatting can be useful in making your data more readable. Here's how you do it. To adjust column widths, place the cursor between two field names so it becomes a double-headed arrow. Click and drag the column separator lines to adjust the widths of the fields. To sequence or index your data, double-click on any column header. An arrow will appear in the header pointing upwards to show that the data has been indexed in ascending order. To index in descending order, double-click the header again. Anytime data is indexed, it is indicated in the Indices area of the Properties window. To remove an index and return to the original ordering of data, click No Index. It's also possible to change font, the font colors and size, background colors, as well as how negative numbers are indicated. In the Database window, right-click any field name to show a list of frequently used tasks. Select Column Settings. Customer number is selected in the field list, so we can change how this data is displayed. I am going to make my text color blue, and I'm going to change the background color to be a light gray. I'm also going to make my font bold and click OK. Next, I'm going to adjust how the credit limit is shown. I'm also going to change my text color. In this case, it's going to be purple. My background will also be light gray. I'm not going to change the font at all. But this is about credit limit, so we're talking about money. So in this case, I do want to see a currency symbol and use a 1000 separator. Now, the currency symbol and the 1000 separator come from the regional settings of your computer. So depending where in the world you are, you may see different indicators. You might see a dollar sign, you might see a pound sign. I'm using United States regional settings, so I'm going to see a dollar sign. Make any further changes you wish and click OK. Now the columns themselves can also be reordered by first clicking the header to select it, then clicking and holding the mouse button, and this will allow you to pick up your column and drag it to a new location in the data grid. So I'm going to move my credit limit to just after the customer number field, and the red line which appears shows me the new location of the column when I release the mouse button. To remove any formatting changes which have been applied, go to the View tab and click Reset in the Views group.